Here we are, born to be kings. We're the best things I've ever been. All right, here we are, March 2016. It's me, Devin, and
Kevin, playing the Killer Queen.
And we are on the Killer Queen's personal session. So, listeners, I guess for Kevin, because I don't think you were here for this.
No.
Ish. To recap, you guys decided not to go to Mahasushi's place, because that was just a ridiculous plan, and instead stayed home, and you all decided to do your own things to prep for how to deal with Wanmei and stuff, and just to get out of people's hair.
Mm.
You people are fucking impossible to live with on the best of days.
Yeah.
So, at this point, the sea wolf, or the wolf, or whatever his name is, has left with the Vermilion Legion, all of it, 1,000 ghost soldiers strong.
Oh, there go our guards.
Oh, and some Dragon Kings, and he took the Rose Black.
Hmm.
And, golly, did he take the ship? I don't think he took
didn't.
The ship.
He force marched them the whole way, yeah.
Yeah, he just walked. So he's gone now.
He's gone.
All right. Yeah, so people are talking about the Elemental Court of the South is fudging with you guys. People are talking about setting up different things. The Majestic is working on artifice and construction projects. The Seawolf is gone, and I guess the Wanderer is going to do, like, a martial arts tournament eventually.
Yeah, wasn't there one going on already?
There's one going on. He might get involved. I have no idea what his tournament is going to be like. So yeah, we'll see what the Wanderer is up to when we get to Anthony.
Okay. Okay, well, my thing is going to be finding this fucking child who's been missing for, like, a year now.
That goddamn sidereal child? Or yes. That child the sidereal stole?
Yes.
That baby you made way back in season one?
Two. That thing I remember when it's convenient? Yes.
Yeah, the thing you made in season two where you had your first tantrum?
Yes. The first
Fuck
of many.
That was a good tantrum.
Every time it happens, someone almost dies.
Okay, so there is information about the child, I guess, coming on in from the C team is back.
Oh, goody.
Hey, Nicole. Look, it's you on the screen. Do you see Nicole?
Are the...
I, what the fuck is that noise?
The vacuum?
But the mini one.
The tiny vacuum?
It's probably packed away.
Yeah, it's in one of those three places.
Anyway, I'm gonna have the magic meeting room set up with the C team.
The C team is back. The C team was, I think, clad in darkness. Those two dragon-blooded chicks.
The Lunar and her boyfriend.
The Lunar and her mate. The Solar.
I love how he's the Solar, but we always call, like, him her boyfriend.
Yeah, the Lunar's kind of the dominant one. She's the one that's in charge. He's just... He's
he plays
a musician.
Music. She married that type.
Oh my god.
What cast is he?
He's a Twilight cast.
Like you.
He focuses on occult and lore.
You're equal.
And a bit of medicine.
Been like a bureaucrat cast or something. He had to be my cast.
He also favored in music. Ugh. Your disdain.
Go away.
Yes, he is the pee pants, as you guys call him, is a Solar Exalt who is directly based off of Edward from Final Fantasy IV, except that Anna, instead of dying like a bitch, is some sort of horrible Lunar Exalt that probably smokes.
Also, we all live for so long that I'm just going to make sure that no one ever forgets that name for him for all the thousands of years he lives.
Oh my god. Maybe...
Let it be written down in history.
Oh my god.
The Queen's first victory.
A victory! Okay, so I had those Dragonblooded's names, but I don't remember it anymore, so that's not important. Just don't... They're two water-aspected Dragonblood sisters. One is a Lost Egg, one is from the Realm. I don't even remember their house name. Not important.
Tina and Turner. Okay.
Doesn't matter. And then you have P-Pants, and his name is... fuck. Like Desert Melody?
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah, and the Lunar Chick's name... God damn it if I don't remember. I think it was, I don't know, something.
Lady Wolf's a lot. Okay.
It's like, her spirit animal's like a stag. She has like antlers and shit.
Mm-hmm.
And like the silver tattoo. She hung out with Mahasushi for a while. I think her name's like, I don't even know. I'm not even going to justify giving her a name.
I just picture walking around the magic meeting room, and they keep getting caught in the webs, and they're, like, draping behind her.
Ah, yeah, the swan is up there.
God.
In its nest.
God nesting. Damn it. Right, and then also Clad in Darkness, and...
Clad in Darkness, again, to kind of round that out for you listeners, if you've forgotten, Clad in Darkness is Gobez from Final Fantasy IV. Just a big, scary, abyssal eclipse dude in armor who doesn't sit down or anything, and has, like, a giant, long purple cape trimmed in black and gold, and he looks awesome.
And Knight of Curses.
She wasn't actually part of the C team, because you had her doing other shit.
I thought she came back after a while, but okay.
Yeah, she wasn't part of the C team and their exploration into... They went to the underworld and tried to find like prophecies and lost knowledge in the labyrinth and stuff. One of this just this whole thing.
Hmm.
They're all decked out in like you know underworld gear. They have like grave goods and like old Orichalcum weapons and soul steel stuff and ghost panoply things.
Well, good for them.
They want to they raided the underworld. They had a great time.
Awesome. They had their own adventures.
They had their own adventure. Wouldn't even show up as a sequel to one of your games.
So yeah, I guess we're all just kind of crowded in the room. Queen's kind of had it decked out with food and shit and wine.
Yeah.
Alright, so, tell me what you found.
Alright. I'm just gonna pause. Okay, Clad in Darkness, at the opposite end of the table from you, standing. What was your question?
What did you find?
We quested through the underworld, traveled through the bowels of the labyrinth, saw buried lunar surfaces from memories of the Neverborn long forgotten, waving his hand theatrically, and came across no evidence of your child. But there were hints, rumors, impressions left in the dreams of the Neverborn in their deepest catacombs.
Do tell.
There is an organization, a cult, a covenant that comes down from Yushan, and they conspire to gather the lawgivers birthed anew and provide them a sort of refuge against the storm of the realm.
I see, so it's a possibility they stole this child to protect them from something. I can't imagine what, but,
perhaps. Perhaps your composition, your masterpiece, as it were, provided some value to them. They are not what some would consider honorable.
I see.
They work to bring about an usurped rulership back to creation. There's not much that can be said about them other than insanity, desperation.
So they support us, but in an underhanded manner of way.
Their enemies would be every part of the world that overthrew you. Could they afford to be anything less? Yes, it's clearly Gobez, Nicole. Very good. Very good kick.
Have you gathered any evidence of where I might find them?
This cult of the Illuminated, as they call themselves, has many mortal limbs stretching out into creation. Cells in a terrorist organization would be the best analogy.
I see.
Small, non-valuable, separate from the others, easy to replace if destroyed, easy to absorb into another part if dispersed or found.
That'll make this difficult, I see. Well, have you found a possible location for one of them? If we find one, I'm sure they can rat out the others.
The best divinations we could find would lead us to the city of Nexus. It is one of the few places that your kind are left unmolested without being under the heel of a larger organization.
I see. Have any of you been to Nexus?
The Lost Egg is like, I have, and Peepants is like, I went to school there to learn to learn the lyre.
Okay, dragon-blooded. What do you know about it?
Gotcha. It's Nexus. What? Have you ever heard of Nexus before?
Haven't been there. Heard of it.
It's a city where anything goes. There's not really any laws there. Like, you're not supposed to disrupt trade, and if you do, you'll instantly die from some sort of infinitely powerful bureaucrat that runs the place. The realm doesn't have any hold there. Yeah, you can't bring an army in there, and if you disrupt trade, you'll die.
Guild run?
The guild is in Nexus, but the Council of Entities runs Nexus.
Right, well, that sounds like our next stop. Let's see. Clad in darkness. Kind of waves her finger around. Past the solar. What's... Lunar. Nightman.
Nightman's not even in the room.
She points to the servant. She's like, Nightman. Go.
Nello leaves the room to go get Nightman.
What was he even doing in here? I thought I had the doors barred.
Yeah, you had a servant barred, and you just didn't realize it was Nello.
Anyone else think they can serve a purpose on this trip? Anyone?
What? My lord, if I may offer a counterpoint.
Sure.
Perhaps the full might of my compatriots, my brothers and sisters in darkness, could counterbalance your more eccentric decision-making.
You make a good point. Let's go with that.
He waves his arm in his cloak, and the other people get up and kind of leave the room.
All right.
You know, as he was walking around the table and talking and just kind of talking through that giant visor he has, he actually did casually pick up the Nightcast skull that he used to drink from and hold in his hand, like, Yorick's skull and talk in soliloquy to it. You know.
It's just like a prop everyone uses.
Oh, yeah. Like a fucking Shakespeare caricature. And then just gently placed it down in his mailed hands.
Daddy.
Why did you leave me?
All right. My servant killed you. All right. We'll get Mongrel to take us there. Ship, easy enough, unless you have another way.
Ooh, the skyship got wrecked, so you're going to have to use one of Shockwaves.
That's fair enough.
All right, you leave the magic meeting room. Okay, so you're at the skyship platform, and one of those weird Matrix-style... alchemical ships is there. Like, I don't know how to describe it to you listeners. It looks like the Nebuchadnezzar from the Matrix. If you haven't looked it up by now, I don't know what to tell you.
It's kind of scrappish. And...
It's like, it looks like a dragonfly with a bunch of dome wheels on it that give off lightning, and like it has like a bubble forward window. The Matrix's ship, Nebuchadnezzar, like, how much time am I supposed to invest re-equating you guys on what the ships look like? Come on! Anyway, so you're there. It's you, clad in darkness, who Gobez, Final Fantasy IV, Abyssal Eclipse cast. Big dude in armor, gold and purple and black, cape, pauldron, spiky shoes, like the whole thing. The Topaz Lady, which is a woman in like a Ragnarok Online priest outfit that's orange skewed and her face is blurry and she carries a giant Gormal that has a huge topaz crystal as the hammer for the Gormal, and has Hearthstone socketed everywhere.
Hmm.
Then you've got... fuck. Knight of Curses, mm-hmm. Which is a slender-framed, purple-haired, vampire-looking chick in the clothes of the Tatari from Melty Blood, because it's just Sion Tatari from Melty Blood in the male Tatari's clothes. Like, guys, I do not do original characters, okay? I take an image, I take a reference, I take a visual, and I strip it out and I put it into the game. So yeah, pale vampire chick, long, single braided, purple hair, fangs, red eyes. They all have their cast marks. You know, she's wearing vampire robes, basically. I think in Exalted she'd be styled more like a hopping vampire.
Hmm.
So, I don't know, maybe a little like Heese and Co. without the ridiculous cheesecake. And, oh, I guess Void of Him Without's there.
Oh, yeah, he is.
Void of Him Without, again, 10, maybe 13-year-old kid. Pale, creepy, long dark hair, wears funeral garb. Like, Asian funeral garb. Why am I here? What is happening?
We're going to Nexus.
Oh, gross.
You can just stay in the car if you want. It's just, you know, a bonding experience. I never see you with your circle, so, you know.
Yeah, because we're functional. We're high functioning. We're good. We don't need to see each other or hang out or talk about each other's lives.
That sounds really boring.
Well, we haven't blown up our city yet.
What city?
Yeah. Nah. We also didn't tell you guys about it, so there's that, too.
That's wise. We'd go there.
You wouldn't want that. You definitely would. Definitely would.
Alright, everybody on.
You all pile in to the alchemical ship. One of those weird triangular kind of papier-mâché metal-looking things that Shockwave just produces is in there as your pilot.
Oh, I guess we don't need Mongrel at all.
Now, Mongrel's probably in the base for when the Majestics game happens, because, oh my god, the Majestics session is going to be a nightmare.
Oh, boy.
You all get up and start to fly. So, yep, it's you and the four Abyssals. For the next... it's going to take probably, like, a couple days to get to Nexus via flight.
Yeah, yeah.
These ships have to stop and recollect essence every once in a while. They're not, like, the first-aid ship. They're Magitech. Okay. They have moving parts that need to be fixed. And they have more of those little folded-up metal papier-mâché people folded up in different compartments to come out and do repairs work and stuff.
Useful.
Yeah. They're not robots. They're people with souls and feelings and stuff, you know.
We probably repeatedly hurt them along the way.
God almighty.
That's just who we are as people.
Yeah, yeah, sounds like you. Yeah, the Abyssals kind of just meditate most of the time. You know, they're in the not Shadowlands, so it's easier to kind of meditate and get a connection to the underworld.
Just kind of observe them, if they interact at all, or like if they talk, or...
Sometimes Clad in Darkness and the Topaz Lady will argue scripture.
Scripture of what sort?
Immaculate Philosophy.
Really?
Yeah. They'll use different Immaculate texts from, like, Luxai, Shogunate Era, Current Realm Era, or, like, Stuff the Mouth of Peace is currently said, and whatnot, and they'll just go back and forth on it.
Who's the Mouth of Peace again?
The Mouth of Peace is basically the Pope for the realm.
Oh, that guy who really hates the current leader because he does terrible things to the scripture.
Yeah, yeah, the current regent, Regent Foku, who's one of the Empress's kids, who's a little senile, a little long in the tooth, constantly masturbates to the Bible. He's not a great guy.
Gross.
Like, he is like a Leslie Nielsen character in Game of Thrones. He is inappropriately placed as the current emperor in waiting because no one else would trust anyone else to be there but him because he's so incompetent. He is so harmless.
Good.
All the other houses have put him as emperor in waiting, quote unquote, because he's just so useless.
Mm. So you don't have to worry about him starting a war that he can't win or something.
He spends most of his day with Milk of the Poppy, and by Milk of the Poppy, I mean he's a drug addict and an old man and crazy.
Just cranking it.
Just jacking it constantly. He is not an inspiring leader. They are doing plays about how much he sucks. The Mouth of Peace is the Pope, and they're just like, oh, come on. This is the worst. Will the Empress come back?
Well, the Queen doesn't know much about... scripture or anything like that, so she just kind of listens in and...
Yeah, it's... I want to say it's interesting, but it's not really that interesting. They're just, they're debating religion.
Mm.
And, like, not even in a heated, you know, adversarial way. They're just trying to basically get one up on each other using different interpretations of religion.
Okay. I'm gonna find Void, then.
He is there or near them. Him and, Knight of Curses kind of just sit meditating nearby.
Mm. Queen
like,
sit
back to the wall.
Yeah. Queen kind of sits down with her smoke. It's like, so,
Did your master say anything after we left?
Yes, he gave me the Majestic's task that the Majestic's prompts to do for me to deliver to you to the Majestic, and I did.
Oh. Okay, nothing else, no. I got them.
No, he didn't even mention it once.
He's a better man than we.
I don't think he even mentioned it after the cleanup operation happened.
Hmm. How many people did they lose exactly?
Half
of all Thorns.
The traitorous half. The half that thought they could stand.
I see.
The half that dared to have hope. My lord put it.
He has a way with words.
As he said, there are always more mortals. They're currently importing more into the Thorns to help with the population problem.
From where?
Surrounding countrysides. Prisoners from other realms. The Mask of Winters has offered to buy up criminal contracts from prisons in the surrounding area. So the worst of the worst go to Thorns, and the Mask of Winters pays out from the Thorns' purse to those nations. They like the arrangement very much.
I can imagine.
Yes, Thorns is making quite a name for itself in the political landscape, or so I'm told by Clad in Darkness. He tends to negotiate many of these dealings.
Hmm. So, you ever been to a... That's what we're looking for.
Nexus?
Nexus.
Yes, several times. I was part of several exploration projects. There are tombs in Nexus, you see.
Tombs?
First Age Solar tombs. They died in the old city that Nexus was, and were buried there.
You didn't sound thrilled about going.
Nexus is superfluous. Nexus is pointless. Nexus shouldn't exist.
Why is that?
Anytime we hear of anathema, or strange gods, or what's that... What's that ETA term they use? That pauper term, adventurers. Anytime you hear about those types of people or anything strange or out of the ordinary or iconoclastic, it inevitably happens in Nexus.
Hmm.
To the point where they talk about Nexus more than they talk about the rest of the world. If you spent your days in Nexus, you wouldn't know that Thorns was creeping up from the south. You wouldn't even know that the Emperors had disappeared. You would barely cogitate that there was an empire of lawgivers rising up from the south, turning the sand into diamond and glass. It's a pointless realm.
It's a self-important bubble.
There's no one that runs it. It's just that's where vagabonds and people without purpose tend to flock to. Your scavenger lords, people who delve into dungeons for old First Realm artifice and shogunate baubles. Aimless people with no purpose other than to hit the nearest tavern to find the next lead. It's an irrelevant city.
Well, we'll make this visit short. As short as it can be, at least.
It's also impossible to do anything about it.
Why is that?
Their emissary. This is one of the things I had been poking into on my previous encounters with the city. There is a council of entities, which are just men, women, people, and they're killable. Shockingly killable. But the emissary has been around since the contagion. It's a masked figure that goes around spooking and murdering people whenever they get in the way of Nexus.
I see.
And it's invincible.
Just straight up invincible?
Well, we haven't tested it against... We were to test its metal against our soldier, our Dark Knight, but he's no longer with us. And I could think of no way to properly position your Wanderer into destroying the Emissary. Though, I suppose I could just tell him that he couldn't, or the Emissary told him that he sucked. And that would probably suffice.
Probably. I can't argue that.
But then the Wanderer could die, and then where would your little tin pot dictatorship be?
I can't even think.
So, it's not worth it until we find something worth throwing at the emissary. It's frustrating that it exists.
Have you tried poisons?
It's a thing. I haven't even struck against it.
All right.
We haven't struck against it. Others have and have failed.
Why do you care so much about it if it can die? Just simply because it's...
It's just irritating. If the emissary wasn't there, I could just have my own resources steamroll through Nexus.
Is that defenseless otherwise? Just adventurers, not attached to the place?
Lost eggs, dragon-blooded. The guild has holdings there. It seems to be their headquarters. But that's less important. The guild can go anywhere.
True enough.
Those tombs would be nice to loot. But even them, they're much more advanced than usual first age tombs.
Traps? Mazes?
They have defenses on their entrances that are impossible to breach. One of them is part of the Firewander district. Called that because the entrance to the tomb itself are plates that run so hot they burn jade and melt or chalcum. Blacksmiths have set up on the periphery of these plates and used the kind of edge of the plates as their forges. Like, economy has been built around the Firewander district, but yeah, anything that walks onto it burns to death. It's incredibly boring.
Sounds like something Majestic would cook up.
Perhaps. There's another one made of skulls that if you walk in, lights come from the skull's eyes and shred you like guillotines. Earth Aspect went through in a Warstrider a couple centuries back, and the Warstrider's shredded fuselage is still in there.
That place sounds miserable.
They're all like that.
What a strange, unpleasant-sounding place.
There's also a wild bubble in the middle of Nexus. Unformed chaos. Just in the middle.
What? How does that even happen?
I don't know. I didn't investigate the lore of the place. It's just there. I try not to spend as much time thinking about Nexus as the next scholar. It's an irritating place.
It does sound like that. Alright.
You'll never hear someone in Nexus talk about the North or the West. They'll never come up.
Insular, I guess. Is there anything we'd have to look out for there? Anyone gonna cause us trouble for no reason?
Don't disrupt trade in Nexus, and you'll inevitably run into assassins.
Of course.
Nexus is full of Realm and Lukshayan and Heslanti Legion and Underworld and Infernal Assassins. It's full of them. It's a central staging point for the entire East, South, and North.
Makes sense.
It's in the middle. It's by Great Forks and the main river. The river that leads straight to Lukshai and then straight to the Blessed Isle. It's a thoroughfare. It's a strong trade city.
Which must make it equally annoying that it's so unusual.
I understand Great Forks. Great Forks is run by three gods that are rebelling against heaven. Great Forks has Great Forks turned back a rival of my liege. You wouldn't have heard of her, but she was like the Mask of Winters, and she went to conquer Great Forks, and Great Forks turned her back and threw her off.
Interesting. I wasn't aware your master would bother with rivals.
It's the nature of his existence. He has contemporaries.
Equals.
So to speak. Different areas of expertise. You've never heard of the general, or the machinist, or the blasphemer, but they exist. And there was one, and she was turned back from Great Forks. Great Forks, I understand. It has its own power structure. It has gods that manipulate fate and destiny, and narrativism that run that place. Nexus is inexplicable. Something's propping Nexus up, and I hate it.
Yeah.
I would trade every scrap of loyalty I had to my liege to see Nexus wiped off the map and a crater put where it was, and every person who lived there or liked that place put to death. I just hate Nexus a lot. If there's one thing I get emotional about still, it's that place.
I was gonna say, that's the most animated I've heard you speak of a place.
I just really hate that place. It's garbage.
Well, we'll make her stay brief then.
I'm going to pause and get a drink.
Okay.
Anyway, unless you want to hang out with any other abyssals, that's void within without's little on the ebon. What was it? The ebon hawk, and you're doing your little side quest thing. That's his little dialogue.
I don't think I'm going to approach any of the other ones yet. We'll see where things go. See which ones seem interesting.
All right. Nexus has a kind of landing area for skyships. And it's not like they have security or anything. It's Nexus. It's, fucking, what's the name of that place in Star Wars? Sky of, High of a Scum and Villainy? Mos Eisley? Yeah, Mos Eisley.
Okay, well, we have the little origami people, so we'll just keep them there.
Yeah, so, yeah, you start to land the thing on the giant fields they've cut out. Nexus is, Oh, shit, I should look up what Nexus looks like again. It's been a while. Okay, so, here we go. So Nexus is at the convergence of two rivers, like just two giant rivers. Mm-hmm. It's kind of like a peninsula that juts out between them. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, you'll probably land somewhere on the outer ring. There's like walls everywhere and towers. Like, as you come on in, Nexus itself is covered in large parts of it by, like, thick black snow or ash pumping up from the industrial districts. Because mm-hmm. they have, like, industrial pig iron, iron town districts here and there.
Mm-hmm.
And then the more first age cities, because this place used to be built on a first age city called, I think, Hollow. There's like 6 to 10 story towers that are connected by bridges and catwalks jutting out everywhere. And then like ramshackle straw and wood huts built on the ground for poor people to live in. And there's like sluice canals and, stuff like, what's the word for those little boats that go down those cities that are built on rivers? I think it's just canals. Like,
yeah.
Like those cities, like, shit.
Canals in Venice?
Venice, yeah. Venetian-style kind of canals everywhere. Streets and roads. There's pulley cars that are pulled by slaves mm-hmm. that pull cars through the more industrial parts.
Gondolas.
Gondolas. That's gondolas, the word.
Yes.
Yeah.
Me and my terrible pronunciation.
And you'll probably land into the docking area, and they'll have room for you, and they'll just kind of flag you down.
We would make room otherwise.
Yeah. And yeah, there's gateways that lead into Nexus, because Nexus is just this little peninsula, and there's just an entryway from land, and then just from the sea. And as you're flying over, you can see people lined up on the roads trying to get in, like, they're just being stopped by tax collectors collecting the entry fee. You gotta pay 1 silver coin to get into Nexus, for every person and animal.
Did children get, like, a half silver?
No, they count as animals. If a chicken's paying a silver, a kid's paying a silver.
Oh, god damn it, Void. Alright, god, we have like jade. I'm gonna assume with resources 3 I have some fucking silver.
Yes,
on
you have
though,
silver,
so.
Oh my Christ. Oh my god.
So we just kind of shove our way in.
Yeah, you guys land inside Nexus basically, and just park your skyship next to like the docks area for where boats are. Your skyship is probably airtight, so you could probably just land at a dock and dock in.
Yeah.
And your crewmen will just seal up the ship.
Yeah.
And yeah, as you guys are trying to file out, Nell is like, "Don't worry, my lord, we'll take good care of her."
Ah! Where the fuck did you come from?
You brought me aboard, sir.
What? When? Did anyone see him come on?
No, everyone's filing out.
Yeah.
Yeah, remember after the meeting, you're like, "You guys, I need you to come hang out on my ship and pilot it. Where's Slummonger all?" And then he wasn't around, so I just came on board.
Just closes the jet wire lock in his face. Seals it tight.
See you later, Anathema buddy.
I hate him. I wonder how airtight we can make this.
Just drown it. Drown it all. Fuck you, Nello.
Alright, I'm not covering up my symbol at all. It's just kind of there on her face. Well, she's not doing that, but she always has it on her forehead, so it's like...
Alright, they take your money and don't care.
Good.
So, Clad in Darkness throws down the Council of Entities kind of rules at you, which is, you can't. No taxes shall be raised save by the Council, none shall obstruct trade, none shall bring an army into Nexus, none shall commit wanton violence, none may falsely claim the Council's name or sanction, none shall harbor a fugitive from the Council's wrath. That's it. Those are the only rules.
Can we defend ourselves if we're attacked? Does that count under wanton violence?
Well, you're not committing wanton violence, you're defending yourself.
Okay.
Muggers, oh, okay, so to just kind of give you an example of just how serious this is, muggers out for someone's purse will quickly apologize if their victim misinterprets an attack as a demand for tariffs, or as being based on location and not mischance.
So with enough social, I could just be like, oh god, you're taxing me?
This is a taxing! What, really? You're gonna go, like, fuck me always sunny team and cry rape constantly?
Sure.
That's what they do. You're gonna cry tax rape.
Basically.
Jesus Christ.
Have you seen the queen? Have you seen what she accuses people of?
My god.
This isn't anything new.
Mothers turn in their only sons for shoplifting rather than risk harboring a fugitive who obstructed trade.
Wow.
Nexus?
Yeah.
Christ.
This place is a hellhole.
Alright, so, where do we start?
A good question, lawgiver. There are many organizations in Nexus. Some run by the Guild, some run by the Council of Entities, some run by military contracts and more subversive factions. Depends on where you think the best... Where would you go if you were hiding from the Wild Hunt?
From the Wild Hunt. I assume the actual leaders of Nexus, their council, don't appreciate the Wild Hunt entering their city in search.
Wanton violence, not assassination.
Ah, good point.
And they have no power here.
Yeah. Guild wouldn't care, because they're the Guild. If you don't interrupt their trade, they're good.
Do you not have allies in the Guild?
We do. Not sure if it'd be this far east, but, it might be a good start. What was the third one? Mercenaries, right?
Mercenary companies. Scavenger lords tend to make this their base of operations.
Right. They'd be as willing to sell us out as they would be to sell them out, though, so I'd say the Guild may be our best bet for now.
Very well.
I assume they have a headquarters here, so...
They do indeed. Just looking up the Guild HQ. In the Cinnabar District.
The Cinnabar District? I assume it's like the Commerce District?
It's the Cultural District.
Oh.
Libraries, monasteries, upscale shops, art galleries, public ballrooms, theaters, stadiums. It's far above the black smoke that you're constantly getting rained on right now. And there's like black snow raining down on you guys in from where you are.
Gross.
Yeah, it's pig iron ash.
All right, let's...
You see many people choking to death on this stuff just out in the street. Like, they have the big K cancers.
Let's get out of here.
Do you not wish to frolic in the snow of Nexus?
This is disgusting. It's like being at that smoke den in Juan May. You know, when the fans broke down that one time? What a shithole.
Oh my god. So Bastion is the affluent neighborhood. It's the wealth place. It's where merchant princes, guild hierarchs, and the Council of Entities live.
Yeah.
So when you get near it, you kind of get stopped by Lookshy security. Or Lookshy. Nexus security. Which are just, like, guild soldiers.
Okay.
And, like, people from the Bronze Pioneers or the Hooded Executioners.
Are they...
They're mercenaries that the Council of Entities hires to keep everyone on the up and up.
Okay.
So, yeah, just, you know, men and women in mercenary gear that all kind of looks the same. They're soldiers. I mean, God, is there nothing special about them. But they bar kind of the big wall kind of systems that have gates in them for getting to the Bastion District.
Okay. Do I have to pay a toll or something? Is that what this is about?
This is more about you not really belonging here, it looks like. What business do you have in Bastion?
I have guild business. I'm a business partner of theirs down in the south. I'm looking for someone up here, and I figured they could help me.
He kind of like reaches for like a scroll tube and cracks it open and starts going through papyrus ledgers. And what would you say your name was?
Queen of a Thousand Conquests.
Queen of a Thousand Conquests?
Yes.
1,000. I got 98. I got 9,999.
Who? What?
I don't think a I don't think 1,000 is on here, though. He makes that motion with his hands, listeners.
Oh, honey.
That universal pride motion.
Oh, I see where this is going. What do I have to deal with this?
Do you have dice rolls? Raw dice rolls? Are you just gonna pay the bribe and move on?
I don't want to pay this bribe. He's being smug towards me.
A lethal case of smugness.
He's making a fool of me. He does not want to make a fool of the Queen of a Thousand Conquests. Master of small manners. That would, you know, that wouldn't. I could dance at him.
You could.
I could dance aggressively at him.
You could do that.
I shall dance aggressively at him.
My god, roll. Can you get at least 5 successes?
12.
Jesus H. Christ. All right, they let you pass. Jesus H. fucking Christ.
The queen turns around and dances backwards, snapping as she steps backwards into the Cinnabar...
Into Bastion?
Yeah.
All right, you guys move along.
Killer queen.
Yeah, you only need to get like 5 or 6 successes in the system to be like best in the world.
Okay.
So it's pretty good. Yeah. So there are streets that have names and stuff.
Named streets.
Yeah, actually, and they're like really well built. They're first age, they're stately, they're like 12 stories sometimes.
Oh,
they're
Wanmei-ish.
Yeah, they're well put together. Cities that have like kind of rectangular designs to them.
Okay.
Okay, I guess you got information from that guy where the guild house is.
Okay.
So yeah, one of the rectangle, stone white, polished, even though there's like black smoke on the crappy part of Nexus, this place is like gleaming white and marble and stuff. On Donlance Street also, is a guild house. It has a guild symbol on it and stuff.
So I like to think I didn't even answer him when he was like, I just started dancing and then just danced backwards past him.
And the circle of epistles followed.
Yes. Okay, so they have a bell or a...
There's a guy out front. His job is to stay out front and greet guests.
Oh.
He's like, oh, hello.
Yes, I'm the Queen of a Thousand Conquests. I really hope you've heard of me.
Do you have business with the Factor?
I do, yes. I'm looking for someone in the city, and, well, I'm a business partner from down south. They would know
from...
Wanmei.
Okay, just one moment. And he goes, talks to people, they talk to people, he comes back. It's like, oh, yeah, someone can see you. Someone on behalf of the Factor will see you.
Perfect, all right.
They, let you guys in.
Pats him on the shoulder, just, killer queen.
Okay, you were brought in to the main kind of... These houses are huge, by the way. Just absolutely fucking enormous.
Huh.
So you were brought up a few floors to a kind of meeting room slash art gallery where there's, like, chaise loungers and chairs, and there's some animals in cages that are on display.
Mm-hmm.
Some just weird stuff from the east and whatnot, like sugar gliders that are big.
Oh, no.
Yeah, and just, you know, animals.
Mm.
Birds, you know. It's nice. It's like a little... What do you call it? Menagerie.
Atrium. Oh, menagerie.
Maybe an atrium, sure.
Okay.
A man walks in, and he has, like, some people with him who look like they're accountants.
Okay.
It's like, we were not expecting the killer queen of Wanmei to grace us with her presence here in Nexus.
Oh, that's fine. Nobody ever expects me, so, you know.
How can we help you here in this branch of the guild?
I'm actually looking for my child. Someone took them a while back, and I've heard that someone with connections here might have... Not in the guild, of course. I would never accuse you of such things. Someone in Nexus itself.
Kidnapped your infant?
Yes. Have you ever heard of, what was the name of the, Cult of Illuminated?
I'm gonna roll for this guy to see if he's ever heard of the Cult of the Illuminated. Let's see how competent this fucking cult is. What does that sound? Oh, I think it's a train. Where the fuck's that dice roller? There it is. Okay. Yes, they're like a what's the term we're looking for? They're like a peasant cult.
Yeah,
like a peasant religion.
That sounds about right.
Yes, they're some. What do you want to know about them?
Where they gather? Who they answer to?
There's a shrine to the Golden Lords or whatever they have in the Firewander district. It's sort of like a It's like a hearth religion, you know. They believe that a shining savior is going to come and lead them into tomorrow, and they won't have to break their backs working for once in their miserable lives.
Have they just never heard of what's happening down south? You think?
No one hears about anything outside of Nexus.
That's tragic.
Yeah, sure. They could be talking about, you know, the lawgivers, but you guys are just another, you know, group of weirdos, like the Dragon-Blooded or your Abyssal friends. You're just strange folk.
Yeah, fair enough. Alright, that was really all I had to ask.
Alright, would you like a place to stay?
That would actually be really nice.
Sure, you feel free. You're one of our, you're an honored guest here at our place.
You flatter us, me. Possibly them. I suppose since you've done us a nice turn, is there anything we can help you with?
You know, now that you mention it, I've been having problems with this scavenger lord we've been contracted to retrieve something for us. Your territory, actually.
Really?
Yeah, usually these don't go through me, but he started here in Nexus, and I haven't been able to get my counterpart in the south to deal with the problem, so this would actually be quite fortuitous for me.
Okay.
Ever heard of Paragon?
Oh, I have, yes.
Okay, this scavenger lord came in here saying that he had records from the First Age that talked about some sort of First Age panoply that belonged to the rulers of the city before the fall. And we paid him a fair amount to give us results, which he did, as down payment, and we haven't heard from him since.
I see, and he's somewhere down in the south?
We suspect he'd be by Paragon.
Alright.
I could have the details sent to you, your skyship.
You do that, and I will do you this solid.
Perfect. How very agreeable.
Sounds about right. All right, so, what time is it?
It's probably midday.
All right, well, we'll just... I assume the rooming is, like, here.
Yeah. Awesome. Yeah, they'll give you a room in this big, giant place they have.
All right, well, we're gonna head out for a bit and, try and figure a few things out, and... Thanks again.
Oh, by all means, lawgiver. This is excellent.
I'm gonna leave. I'm just gonna use the washroom.
Sure, I'll pause. And we're back. Okay, so, this is your base of operations. Where do you go from here?
Alright, so where was that district that contained the Cult of the Illuminated?
I looked it up. So, the Tomb of Red Hot Iron, you know, the thing that's like the super hotted? That's in the Nighthammer District, because apparently the Nighthammer District is the one that has the smithing and stuff in it.
Mm-hmm.
And let's see here. Let me pause. So the actual location of the Cult of the Illuminated, like that he gave you, was the Firewinder District. The Firewinder District is the center of the old city of Hollow, and is the kind of forgotten part of Nexus, because that's where that wild zone exists.
Ah.
It's where the poor live, because it's right by a wild bubble.
So they start mutating and turning into...
Yeah, or just get eaten.
Mm. Sounds miserable.
Yeah. Yeah, there are three neighborhoods living in it that are still standing. Filth, Telnot, and Brookside.
One of those sounds really cheery.
Brookside?
Yes.
Beside a babbling brook.
That sounds nice compared to Filth.
Telnot. Yeah, it's where the old Capitol building is.
It's like half of this place is like covered by gentrification and the other half is just the ghetto.
Yeah, Nexus is just a giant ghetto.
Ugh.
Just, yeah. Oh, the Guild HQ. Here it is. Cool. It's on the map here. Neat. But you can go to the Guild HQ. You went directly to the Bastion District and hung out there.
Mm.
Oh, there's an academic career there called the School of Philosophy. It's kind of like its own kind of occult school.
Oh, neat.
Mm. Man, if only you were at the Majestic.
Yeah. If only. At the Majestic, I build things. I sure hope nobody ever tries to throw a punch at me.
I build things.
Couldn't get the nasally voice going, but...
I know, Majestic. I build things. Yeah.
Okay, so right to the Fire District, then.
The Fire Wander District. Okay, yeah, it's actually just south of the Bastion District.
Oh.
Like, not just south, but the entire length of Nexus south.
Very convenient. Well, I'm just going to get a carriage for there, so. It's like, fuck this walking shit.
Yeah, fair enough. They're easy to hire.
Hmm.
And yeah, Firewinder District has most of the old buildings. They've been shattered and broken. The Capitol building is covered in kind of a miasmic fog where there's lightning coming out of it every once in a while and thunder.
Mm.
And just like strobing lights.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of like an alien abduction site that's cloaked in stuff.
Mm-hmm.
When you get really close to getting a vantage point on like a hill to look down to where the Capitol building is, some of it looks kind of like Jupiter, like the dome kind of spinning around it.
Oh, pretty.
Yeah. A little bit like, for the reference, that shield that was on Shackenzar.
Right, yeah. Hmm. Just tear that right open.
Phew, fuck. That'd be a problem.
It'd be a problem for Nexus.
Trade would be disrupted.
It's like, we're leaving.
Yeah, Nicole, you weren't here, but Kevin got the first rise out of Void Within Without emotion-wise.
Oh no, what'd he do?
He asked him about Nexus, and Void Within Without has strong opinions about how much he hates Nexus.
Really?
Yeah.
Interesting.
The end result of that conversation, I think, was Void Without saying, I would trade every piece of loyalty I ever had to my liege if someone took Nexus, destroyed it from the map forever, and ripped up the place it stood on and killed every person who ever liked to live there.
Why does he hate Nexus?
It's unpredictable and doesn't make sense.
Yeah, on a meta aspect, it's because Nexus is the shittiest part of the Exalted setting.
It's Adventurer Town.
Yeah, it's Adventurer Town. It even has, like, impossible dungeons, and, like, every faction lives there, and, like...
There's probably a Shadowlands.
Oh, yeah. Oh, there's an Undercity, too, so you can do underground delving for dungeons and stuff. It's, like, take all the diversity of Exalted ever and cram it into one city, and that's Nexus. It also has an impossible-to-beat superboss that keeps you from fucking up the city or changing it too much.
Lame.
Called the Emissary of Nexus.
I have a question. Emissary, never mind. How does the person control... I think their name is Jem?
Paragon, you mean?
Paragon?
It's a staff.
Yeah, the Perfect of Paragon has a moon, Sailor Moon staff.
And, like, he says a law and it becomes...
Some shit like that.
Something?
It's a magic staff. It's
can
a disco
you, like,
stick.
Steal it from him and go to Nexus and be like...
I think it only works on the one town because it's...
Yeah, I think it's attuned to Paragon.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Do you have to tune it to another town?
Well, it's just built. Yeah. It also has, like, a sister artifact, too.
Interesting.
Yeah, a lunar and a solar set up that place as, like, a social experiment on carrot and the stick. The staff is the stick, and the other artifact is the carrot.
Mm.
So when you're following the law, you feel great.
Mm.
And then when you disobey the law, you feel pain.
Okay.
So it gets you, like, addicted to following the law.
Brutal.
Yeah, it wasn't that bad, apparently.
until this dick took over.
He only has one half of it.
Which makes it even worse.
Yeah, he's also kind of an asshole. He's also a bit of a setting ick, because him and the Empress apparently got into, like, face-to-face, like,
yeah.
diplomacy stuff. Rather than the Empress, I don't know, taking a ship above Paragon and nuking it.
Isn't it possible if you take the, if you have the one that's the carrot, just go into Paragon and set all the rules to be the opposite of what the other one does, so that you just don't feel anything?
I think they'd all die. Because if you disobey the rules enough in Paragon, you just die.
Ah.
That'd be a great way to kill people.
That'd be hilarious.
That makes it so that, like, it makes you addicted to
pain,
not following
because
the law,
it makes it pleasure.
But it also kills you like an actual drug.
Yeah, you just killed everyone in Paragon and laugh.
And it's like, we can just move in new people.
Yeah, with or without, just doesn't like Nexus.
Mm.
He hates it. If you guys were to destroy all of Nexus, like if you were to build a Soulbreaker orb and drop it on Nexus, he would just completely betray the Mask of Winter. So he'd be like, yep, that is what I wanted. In my heart of hearts, this is what I truly wanted.
Now I can ascend.
Yeah, that was
funny, because that would make me think that he was from Nexus originally or something, but that's totally not the case.
He just hates it.
He hates how inconsistent the city's written.
this is terrible writing. What
like to put it into perspective, Holden, one of the developers, the bad one, once said, when they were polling how Exalted usually runs, is that 80% of Exalted games are solar games. Of that 20% that aren't solar games, 80% of those are dragon-blooded games. Now, of Exalted games that do happen, probably 60-70% of them take place in Nexus and never go beyond Nexus. Of the percentage that doesn't take place in Nexus, the rest takes place in the South.
Hmm.
Yeah, why is the South so much?
It has a bunch of cities that were just overwritten for it. You have Harborhead, Angten, Chiroscuro.
Angten?
You have the Lap, Paragon, Gem. Hell, the Alchemicals, when the Alchemicals come back to creation, mm-hmm. they come back in the South in the books.
Of course they do.
So the South is where it's at. Like mm-hmm. it has everything written into it. Hell, the Southeast, which is still the South, has Rathis, which is one of the biggest modules in first edition, and it also has Mahasuchi and a few other things.
Mm-hmm.
So the South and Nexus are the biggest places. Like, games don't usually not happen there.
Yeah.
It's one of the reasons why I have the Alchemicals come back in the North, because who the hell does stuff in the North? There's like four places in the North tops.
Even we didn't do much in the North.
Yeah, no. The North doesn't have a lot of stuff going on for it. It has Whitewall, which is interesting. It has Gethamane, which got kind of shitty in 2nd edition. It has the Heslanti Legion, which are the remnants of that Eye of a Tokthon made city.
Mm-hmm.
And that's kind of it.
Did you invent that Dragon King city?
Nope, that's there. It's just in some supplement somewhere. And the West is just, you know, pirate game, the game. The West is, we wanted to play 7th C, but at a higher level. Mm-hmm. And now there's a 7th C 2nd edition Kickstarter, so we're just going to play that instead of the West and Exalted. The West has a bunch of really bad shit from the Abyssal's book written into it.
Mm.
And then the center of the world, which would probably be the most interesting, the Blessed Isle, no games can really happen except for Dragon-blooded games.
Mm-hmm.
And then the East is actually pretty empty in comparison to the South.
Tragic.
You have Lukshai, you have Nexus, you have Great Forks, you have that Flying Mountain, you have...
The Wilds kind of area.
Yeah, the Wild. Probably the best thing they put into the East was the Dreaming Sea, which is basically a secondary campaign setting directly in the East. It's its own ocean that has its own little shit going on around it.
Hmm.
And Palanquin, which is also Southeast.
Cool.
Yeah.
And the Well?
The Well's not really a thing. I'm talking more like campaign settings you can set a game in. There's not a lot compared to the breadth of stuff in the South. Anyway, what the fuck were you doing? You were going to the Firewander District.
Yep.
So your carriage takes you into the Firewander District, and they're like, hey, do you want us to stay here?
Yeah, nah, we'll probably be a while. We'll just catch another one.
Hooray, and they leave. So it's you and the four Abyssals.
All right. So let's find the shrine, I guess. Let's follow the chanting, maybe?
Oh, there's no chanting. There's poor people, though. Endless amounts of poor people. People with two faces coming out of their one face. People with, like, you know, dragonfly and Cronenberg the fly parts coming out of their back and stuff.
Let's throw money at them until they tell us where to go.
Oh, my God. Voidfilmeth out and Clad in Darkness were like about to like reach out to grab a poor person. They're like, oh yes, we could also do that, Lawgiver.
So yeah, I just start bribing these people.
Okay, once you start bribing them, more people start coming out because you're giving out money, and poor people start to kind of start to get near you.
I have resource 3. I can handle this. I just start like, eh. I saw you twice. You get the fuck out of here. No, your two faces don't count.
I'm Burgess Meredith.
Basically.
The Penguin.
I'm going to picture the Queen as Danny DeVito from now on.
Oh no!
I wish Danny DeVito wasn't every show and movie that existed.
Yes.
I liked him in The Lorax.
But yeah.
Alright, I'll roll social stuff against these poor people so they don't turn into a murder cannibal rape mob. As poor people are wont to do.
Can I dance at
Jesus
them?
Jesus Christ.
I know, right?
No, I'll just social them for once.
Okay. Nine. These aren't just poor people, these are mutants.
Yeah, so 9.
Like Red Dawn style, or that Schwarzenegger movie. Mission to Mars.
I was just fucking watching it, too.
You were just watching Red Planet, Red
Total
Dawn.
Recall.
Total Recall.
That's the one.
You were just watching Total Recall?
Yes.
That's amazing.
9.
Oh, wow, okay, they love you. You're a messiah of some sorts. Oh, shit, you're falling back into your old ways.
Have my money. Go away. Don't touch me.
All right, a little psychic-looking girl from Total Recall shows up. And she's like, okay, kid voice.
If she has a really husky voice.
I was going to be like, hey there, Governor! I'm a little mutant freak!
It's like, oh, I was going to take you back to the city, but,
Oh, God! You're able to get directions.
Okay.
Straight up. It's kind of near the Capitol building in the Filth District.
Gross.
Okay. The filth.
Is this child remotely charismatic or cute at all, the one who gave me directions?
Do you consider pugs to be cute?
No.
Then no.
No, she doesn't get to come to our magical golden city then.
Oh my god.
She can stay here.
Alright. Even that Danny DeVito frog kid?
I like him.
It's like if you ask his dad, it's like, is this Danny DeVito looking kid cute? Do you think Danny DeVito or pugs are cute?
Wait, do they consider like kidnapping children to be like disruptive of trade? Can I just buy these children?
I don't think any of that would disrupt trade in Nexus.
Okay, I mean,
they're probably orphans anyways. Like, if they have parents, maybe give them money.
Okay, the only use they have for these people is they send tax collectors every once in a while.
Okay, I'm gonna take these children and be like, okay, if you want to go somewhere to a magical land that's much better than this one, just be at this dock with the money I gave you. At this time.
Oh man, this looks bad.
Away.
Alright, a bunch of wild mutant kids are gonna show up at your skyship.
Enjoy the ugly. They're probably illiterate too.
I hate you kids.
Jesus.
You're just doing it to prank the Majestic?
Well, it's a teaching opportunity, actually.
This is a teachable moment. Like, you just unload them and start dropping them on the Majestic's, like, art gallery from the ship.
Remember to touch things. I gave you that peanut butter for a reason.
You there with the spider webs. Go at it.
Honk.
That's one ugly kid. Okay, so we head to the shrine.
You should probably tell Nello to let the orphans on board.
All right.
You want to send a letter?
Yes, we'll send a letter. We'll hire a messenger to be like, let those kids on.
All right, some courier sends a letter to Nello to let him know.
Buy them lunch.
Get that bitch a sandwich.
Basically.
Jesus Christ. All right. Anyway, the unwashed masses leave you behind as you get closer to the Capitol building in the Filth District, where there indeed is what looks like a bombed-out cafe or... like tea house or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And like, you know, it's like been melted over and it's been burned out and stuff.
Ugh.
And yeah, there's some people of various genders, ages, and ethnicities and like rags that are hanging out in there and sitting and worshiping at a little shrine of like a little sun made of like crappy rusted metal.
This is awful. Why did we come here again? I'm starting to forget. We need to do this quick. Okay.
Which one looks like a leader or a preacher or something like that?
There's one that looks like a leader. He has, like, a sunburst on his forehead, like, tattooed on. What do he also know? Has a bunch of prison tattoos.
What do I know about the serial that kidnapped this child? Like, what they were wearing or anything?
Goddamn nothing. Because it's really hard to remember what they look like.
Even their clothes or anything like that?
Yeah.
We knew she was wearing a mask, though, right?
Yeah.
I'm looking for a woman in a mask.
People that kind of turn to look at you with their insmouthy fish eyes and mutant faces.
Gross.
I can only imagine you always saying that out loud, too. Just they look
she has been saying it nonstop since she got here.
Gross.
She has, like, those wet wipes, so she's just kind of like, She, like a child gets too close, she's like,
Jesus Christ, Kevin.
You're right, this place is awful. Yeah, a woman...
Void's like, yeah, see?
A woman in a mask. She's probably clean, she doesn't have dirt on her. I'm the social character.
Cloud of Darkness places his mailed hand on your shoulder.
You want to do this?
If I may.
By all means.
Him and the Topaz Lady walk among them, and, like, he puts his hands out, and, like, some people are getting up or look afraid, and they just kind of sit down and look a little sullen, a little kind of, drugged out as he just waves his hand around them. As he's walking his shadow, by the way, his shadow isn't a shadow. His shadow, as it goes across the pews and, like, goes across people, is, like, twisted into this long, coiling Chinese dragon with a malicious grin across it. And, like, it's, like, hitting people in the back of the neck with its tongue, and they're just sitting down, being docile.
The queen kind of touches Void on the shoulder. It's like, I like your friends. They should stay in the city. With us.
They're often doing the work of my liege.
I'll find them a room.
He walks to the front and just kind of takes up a standing position in front, blocking out their little idol, which in his presence, in the Topaz Lady, as she walks up, she's actually giving off this kind of orange light, which is making those people look kind of attentive at her, like they can't look away. She's anima flaring, but instead of being that kind of black horribleness that Void Without gives off, it's a pure topaz kind of shine. Almost like it's addicting to be around her. You actually kind of feel this kind of almost mescaline-y tug whenever you look at her. And she walks in front of that idol, and as she does, you can see behind her the idol starting to brassen up a bit and rot and kind of defile itself.
That's kind of awesome. I like these people.
Don't let her near our city.
She's always in your city.
What?
We have to replace that seat she's in
she
every
doesn't
time.
Actively defile your shit, but, you know, these guys know demon and undead summoning and stuff. They know what it's like. And she just kind of slams the pommel of her hammer down to the ground and stays there and starts to hover above the stone and gives a sermon about supplication, nihilism, and how love is a corrosive thing that'll eventually leave you hollowed out and dead inside, and that's why nobody's ever come to rise you above your station.
What the fuck, lady?
Wow. I can see where you get it.
Oh, we haven't got to the good part yet. And then clad in darkness, that shadow goes among them, and going from the back forward, the shadow opens its jaw across people and starts grabbing at their necks. And as it passes over them, and they lose their mutations.
Whoa.
Wow. Does he have medical charms?
He has medical and wild and labyrinth-shaping charms. Right now, they're both turning this place into a mini Shadowland.
Wow.
And then, once it's a Shadowland, they have power here. They give a long-winded sermon about the heat death of the universe and how nothing matters and how only your lives can only get better upon death when you shed the animal part of your soul and only become a higher being. And these guys basically start to fall in line and get a little ashen-looking, a little weird-looking. But basically non-mutated. Gobez kind of beckons to you to come up in the center of the pews. They're all yours, Lawgiver.
Wow, okay. Okay. All right. This woman I'm looking for, she's taken something important to me. Yes. It is a small child that belongs to me.
In the biblical sense.
In the biblical sense, yes. And that's about it. Yes. I know she works with your kind. My friends have granted this boon to you, and I ask you this in return. Lead me in their way. Or lead me her way. Show me her way?
The head priest gets up. He looks really kind of ashen and hungry.
Mm.
His canines look a little sharper than usual.
Jesus Christ.
They might have turned him into vampires.
That's awesome.
It's a problem that solved itself.
They got rid of this really annoying cult and replaced it with their own.
he kind of gets up and like adjusts his clothes, which are hanging a little looser on him. There's a man. He comes by every few months, at least once a season, and he collects a census of the people, of the true believers. He leaves us with boons.
What kind of boons?
Trinkets. Alms.
Show me one.
Okay. He leads you up into, like, the burned-out cafe to, like, his room and, like, pulls out a floorboard under his bed. And there's a little box. And in the box are small, orichalcum and brass rings that have, like, a sunburst on them.
Hmm.
And, like, little yassel crystals that have stuff inside of them.
What kind of stuff?
They're full. Yeah, so crystals usually keep spirits inside of them, and these ones are full.
Can I put one on and try to figure out what it is?
Oh, the ring gives you a mode of essence to spend, as if you had essence.
Oh, I see. Interesting.
Just for any asshole to use.
We should start making these for our people.
Yeah. You don't really need to meet. You can start making them, but like when you open up the Majestic's tomb and your tomb,
mm-hmm.
you found these by like the dozens.
Oh, right, we did. We do have a lot.
These
of
things
them.
Are everywhere.
Okay. Interesting.
And then there are, like, yeah, yassel crystals on, like, strings and necklaces that are full. But like,
it just gives them modes of essence to spend.
Oh, the yassel crystals probably have spirits inside of them.
Okay. What kinds of spirits? Can I, like, sense occult?
No, unless you have, like, occult charms for seeing ghosts.
No, I don't. Oh, but I'm with a bunch of people who might.
Void of them without, just kind of takes them.
Mm-hmm.
They're health spirits.
Okay, simple boons then, yeah.
Yeah, he said if there is ever a plague to befall us, to break one open and entreat with the creature inside.
Huh. Alright. So it's this census taker we should find.
Yeah.
Wow.
He's like licking his lips a little.
Yeah. What's up?
I'm just thirsty.
Oh, this isn't... Is this... Oh, right, it's one of the little
It's creature. One of the people.
I thought it was Void. I was like, what the fuck?
It's a fucking Void.
Okay, I'm just gonna...
That would have been really awkward.
Just push this guy out a window.
Yes. No. Just onto the floor. It's like, okay. We're done here. Census taker, what's he look like?
Older man, probably mid-30s, but looks more weathered, because probably, you know, works. He probably has a place near the Nighthammer District.
Okay.
Because, yeah, people have left here to go around and they see him there every once in a while.
He ever give you a name?
He said he was an apostle of the New Dawn.
Okay. We took the Nightman with us. Did we just leave him in the ship?
You didn't bring Nightman with you. You brought the Abyssals.
Okay. Fair enough.
Clad Darkness, you were like, I'm going to bring all these C-team people.
And
Clad Darkness is like, no. Bring us.
Okay, so...
Let us show you our values. You bring us on more adventures. Involve us more in your life.
Oh, God. They have no idea what they're asking for. Those poor bastards.
I need a drink and go to the washroom, so I'm going to pause. And we're back.
All right, so I guess we're heading to the Twilight District, or
Blackhammer.
Yeah, Blackhammer. Okay. Twilight Hammer Sword, yes, okay.
You guys head out of the Blackhammer District, Night of Curses isn't with you anymore.
Oh, she kind of buggered off?
Yeah, she was with you at the cult meeting, but she's gone now.
I assume she has better things to do. I don't expect these people to, like...
I sent her ahead, lawgiver. I sent her far and wide to the city to cover the shadows. See if we can't find this census taker.
Thank you.
Perhaps speeding this minutia ahead to the point where you find your prize would be a better use of our time.
That would be appreciated. Can I ask something, though? Why are you helping me? I mean, I asked you, obviously, but, why?
I don't understand the pretense.
Why would you help me?
Why wouldn't I, lawgiver? You're a powerful person running a nation in the south. One of the big changers of the world.
Yeah, I guess. It's just...
Well, think of all you offer Oblivion. There are wars coming, lawgiver. Wars that did not matriculate before your arrival upon the face of this creation. And I think someone like you should be rewarded for those developments.
Huh. I can't argue that. War means death. Death means closer to entropy, Oblivion.
All those pretty little words my counterparts will talk of, but I think it's important to frame it in a way that matters the most, and that is, we're going to do great things together, Killer Queen. Great things.
Well, I'll just let you know I appreciate it, so...
That's what I'm looking for. It's like, you are very cordial. It is appreciated in this savage world.
I thought you'd be a bit, that's the word I'm looking for.
Standoffish?
Standoffish, if only due to our little encounter in, Thorns.
My liege is many things, but one to hold a grudge is not something I have seen from him.
Oh, not him. I mean, I know you're all your own people. I wasn't sure if it would inconvenience you at all, is all.
Well, thank you for the consideration. Pardon?
Is everyone else's internet really?
Yeah, we got the wireless in the closet. Until I get a repeater out here, it's going to kind of be like that.
Okay, because I'm taking a bajillion years right now.
Yeah, there's nothing we can really do about that right now. I'm going to look into getting a repeater out here. I'll probably get one off Amazon. I can plug it in here, and then it'll just boost the Wi-Fi through the whole house. Because it has like a throughput through the patch panel we have in the closet. I'm sorry, but it's the best place to put it because there's a patch panel there.
So yeah, I'll head to the Hammer District then.
Okay. Yeah. You guys take a caravan, I suppose.
Yeah, I just keep hiring those everywhere we
need
to go. No,
they're good. They're fast. You eventually get to the pulley system. People kind of give Clad in Darkness a bit of a berth. He's a scary looking dude. He is a giant dude in armor and... He doesn't act like a knight or like some sort of Sauron-esque bully boy warrior, but...
He's like an aristocrat, almost.
Yeah, he carries himself like an aristocrat, and just from the way he talks about religion or about the nature of the world, he acts a bit like a sorcerer. Like, he carries himself like one of those types of people, and people are scared of sorcerers.
A philosopher.
Yeah. He's a bit Doctor Strange for people, and that puts people off.
He's pretty cool.
When you arrive in the Nighthammer District, you immediately see the Tomb of Fire or whatever, which is, you can't see because it's covered by the plates, but there are these giant plates, these squares put down everywhere, and heat from the tomb's defenses are making them super hot, and people on all four sides have set up blacksmiths and whatnot, and kilns and furnaces, and are using the heat to run the Nighthammer District. Beyond the plates of fire, beyond the heat... is perhaps a treasure left by your progenitors, by your other selves. It might be worth coming back here one day and plundering what is yours.
Yeah, can no one just fly over them? Has no one tried?
By whatever do you mean?
Just floating over the tiles, you have to step on them for the heat, or just, I guess they give it off.
The entrance is sealed in the center.
Suppose we could probably use the Majestic to break through it.
He's pretty good with doors. I had a similar thought.
I mean, I've got this buddy, the cloud, just around her.
Just many have over. Tried. None have succeeded. Hmm. It is an incongruent fact, my scholarly associate will bring up, that such a populated area has not pierced this tomb yet.
That is strange. It seems like a place of many unique talents.
Hmm.
Do they know whose tomb it is? Is there any indication?
And time has worn away the outer facade, and there's nothing to point towards who could be buried beneath.
Hmm. Alright, well, where are we headed?
You guys arrived near a blacksmith in Nighthammer, and this is the first time you've seen, like, a lot of, like, industrial people who are working with esoteric materials. Like, this is kind of like Monster Hunter Tribe, where you just have people using, like, parts of things to make equipment.
Monster bits, yeah.
Monster bits, behemoth parts, you know, bones, metal, parts of old artifacts and stuff.
That would make that little bubble of the wild really useful. You can just harvest things from there.
Oh yeah, if you had wild shaping, you can go in there and wild shape stuff out of it. Mm. People sometimes go in there and trade with the fair folk, you've heard. Like, they'll trade people and souls in and out for materials.
Makes sense. There must be a very small court in there, I guess.
Yeah, but...
Or is it bigger on the outside? Is that how it works? Or bigger on the inside?
Yeah. No one really knows. No one really interacts with whatever is in there.
Yeah, I guess if worst came to worst, we could go ask them.
There you go. As you're walking, the topaz lady points you to an alleyway.
Hmm?
This way.
All right.
And Knight of Curses is there, and she like waves to you guys, all happy like. And when in her big long sleeves, she has a guy by his throat up against a wall, who vaguely matches the description that the cultist gave you.
Oh wow! Good job.
Yeah, her nails are biting into the concrete that's holding his throat up because she has long talons.
Mm-hmm.
Found him.
That's pretty great. Man, I'm glad you didn't take those into me during our tournament.
I usually poison tip them.
Yeah.
It's useful.
Did I, like, shake her hand?
Yeah. She pulls her hand out of the wall and grips her under the throat and just kind of moves him down next to you.
Hi.
And she just kind of spikes the back of his neck. Oh.
Oh, thank goodness we didn't need another pee pants on our hands. Right, so, we have questions for you.
Oh, okay.
Who do you answer to?
Oh, I answer to my cell leader.
Your cell leader, and who's that, and where?
She doesn't give me a name. She's in the
pod.
She makes her base in the tomb.
Which one? There's a lot of tombs.
The one by Firewander, the ghost one.
The ghost one? Anyone?
Into dark, clad in darkness. The Tomb of Keen Spirits, Lawgiver. That would be the one most likely to be breached in this day and age. It usually had a legion of specters patrolling it and tearing apart any who entered its periphery, but they've moved on in large numbers in the intervening millennia. There's only maybe 20 or 30 left of the original 1,000.
But one time I don't have the wolf around.
I think you'll find we can be persuasive when it comes to spectral entities.
All right. I assume you don't go to see her. She comes to see you.
Yeah, that's what happens.
All right. Don't tell anyone about this.
Okay. I'm going to. The poison only makes him tell the truth.
Yeah, I guess we're going to have to deal with this. Wanton murder, right. Or wanton violence.
Also, does it really matter?
She just kind of looks at you and pricks him with one of her other talons in the back of the neck and he drops dead.
That's much better.
Yeah, if you just kill them, it's not a problem. You don't have to take prisoners.
Oh, no, I was fine with that. Just, Okay, moving on.
Yeah, they just kind of push him under some garbage.
Wasn't he, like, part of the cult when he illuminated?
She's like, wait a minute. And she snaps one of her talons and he gets up and starts shambling along. There, see? The perfect crime. I don't know why we were hiding the body. You're so new, you're throwing me off my game.
Yeah, how long have you been doing this?
Oh, for a long time.
Yeah, I guess it's kind of rude to ask you your age.
Yeah, you know, I'm old, I guess. Man.
Guessing you were around before the solar started popping up again?
No, I think most of us are from around the time the bull showed up.
Huh.
Yeah, that's before the solar started popping up again, isn't it?
10, 15 years.
Yeah.
Oh.
Right. Alright. So that tomb.
Okay, you guys head all the way back to the Firewander District.
God damn it. Alright, so the spirit tomb.
The tomb of keening spirits is... Okay, you make your way back to Firewander.
Thank God for these carriages.
Yes. The Tomb of Keening Spirits is a plain, ugly vault of gray stone with no entrances. 20 chanting specters ring the tomb all the time, screaming.
I hate this place. Right, so one of you can interact with these things, make them...
The Topaz Lady, they didn't give me stats for these tombs or anything. Like, I guess I could look at the first edition book.
Yeah.
I guess they're supposed to be rough, but you're basically 5 solar exalts, so...
I thought you were saying that she was saying this in character, and I was like, what?
What are you doing with that book?
So, yeah, I'm going to say the Topaz Lady, who's the priest cast.
Cast, yeah.
And you're also the priest cast.
Mm.
You don't have anything to do with priest stuff. In the traditional sense.
I dance.
Yeah, I'm going to say she's going to walk on in with abyssal charms for dealing with spirits, because this tomb clearly calls them out as spirits and specters, not as automated energy defense holograms.
Mm-hmm.
And she is going to clean this fucking tomb up of those 20 specters. They're going to just go away. They're going to be dealt with.
Queen lights up another cigarette. And no one's ever done this before. That is depressing.
I know, right? It doesn't make any goddamn sense. I hate Nexus. This place is such a miserable pile of filth.
Yeah.
To be fair, I don't think one such as us has ever thought to infiltrate one of these tombs. They tend to be an all-or-nothing affair.
Yeah. Alright, well, moving on.
It is lucky that the hubris of your four of your predecessors... did not consider that there would be champions of the dark here to deal with their defenses.
I don't think they ever anticipated anything like you ever appearing.
Well, there's no way in. You all stand, in the Tomb of Knights kind of courtyard where no one else has ever stood.
Mm-hmm.
This place is full of, like, tombstones and, like, graves and, like, little Japanese shrines to dead people and stuff. Topaz Lady has you go through and use your little zenith power to purify the dead specters.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Because, they have material remains left behind.
Mm. Make sure they never come back up
again. Yeah, get rid of these things.
All right. Is there some kind of stupid riddle scripted somewhere, or...
Hmm. And we're back. So I quickly looked over all the pirated Exalted books I have, which is all of them! And I also had to look up a few wikis to find, like, Wikipedia-esque sources. So, Scavenger Sons has information on Nexus, which is basically word for word what's in the second edition information on Nexus.
Cause of course.
Second edition was very big on not writing anything new or overwriting stuff that was already written.
Of course.
Yeah. Second edition was a bit of a train wreck. That's why I don't feel bad about piracy ever. For anything. Because of second edition Exalted. I apply the morals to other game systems and other book lines because of Exalted 2nd Edition. So good. Anyway, so there's no information on the tombs that I could track down easily in my little archives in the 10 minutes I took to do a bit of research. So I'm going to have to wing it. So it's winging it time. Bitch!
Well, we don't have a Dawn cast here, or a... whatever the hell yours was, so we can't just break this down, I guess. I mean, I could after a while, but...
Alright, so the 5 of you are going to inspect this place?
Yes. Just inspect the whole thing.
This is the inspection music from Persona.
Yeah.
All right, what do you guys inspect?
Walls for any scribbling, the graves, the, I guess any of the corpses for anything they might have in them.
Poor people are at the periphery of the tomb watching you guys now.
Pick one of the skeletons. It's like, ugh.
There weren't skeletons. Those were specters.
Ah.
The keening banshees.
Okay. Well, I assume we're creepy enough that they're not going to try to, like, come in. And...
No, no, God, no. No one's ever going to come in to hear you crazy.
That's awesome.
All right. Void eventually goes, well, fuck it. Let's just dig up all the graves.
That's a fun plan. Okay.
Well, not us.
Yeah. You poor people.
Yeah, you pay a bunch of destitute people.
Yes, to dig up these tombs.
All right, done.
You can defile the remains after we find what we're looking for.
You dig up the tomb, and it turns out that this little stone rectangle goes down further.
Oh, okay, so we're just excavating the whole area then.
All right, some more time goes by, probably a couple hours, and yeah, you've excavated a fair portion. It's well into nighttime at this point, and... The Abyssal's like, as much as we enjoy having people do a hard day's labor, why don't we escalate this?
Do tell.
They start doing necromancy.
Yes.
And they necromancy up some sort of skeletal bone creature out of the remains and the corpse dirt and the gravestones that you've defiled. And it starts doing the excavation work for you.
It's like, okay, you're all fire. Take your earnings and go.
Yeah. More time passes. It's probably middle of the night at this point, like deep into the middle of the night. As it just keeps tearing through. It has like multiple skulls for like a large saurian head, basically, and shovel hands made out of broken stone and grave rock. And you're able to excavate down in a spiral until you finally find an entrance.
Oh. How the hell did she get out of there? Ever.
Yeah, all the Abyss is like, that's a good question. Forth and Without is all, It's almost like whoever designed this tomb and the entrances and exits didn't really plan ahead about how someone would get in and out of it.
How stupid.
This would be a really terrible development in a book or something similar.
Yeah.
Just sloppy writing.
Shame on them.
This turns out to be my tomb.
We were making fun of me, Nicole. Me, Devin, as a GM for being sloppy. It was meta, Nicole.
So I know you're making fun of, like, the writers and also, I guess, yourself.
I was, because it's like, how's she supposed to get out of this tomb? I don't know. They had to fucking excavate it for them to get in.
They'll just turn towards the fourth wall and just stare.
I'll probably make up some bullshit about how there's you can leave, but you can't get back in or some nonsense. That's definitely going to happen. Mm-hmm. The top here, you can probably walk out and phase out through the rock or stupid shit.
Okay, let's,
We're making fun of me, Nicole, not you.
No, I know.
We usually make fun of you,
but... Because this place is so stupid, it better not be my tomb.
I'm the Majestic. I make really weird tombs.
I'm the Majestic. I'm so fucking stupid.
Okay.
Keeps happening.
Does this door just open?
The five of you can get it open.
Okay.
Alright, I'm gonna change the soundtrack up. Okay, team. You and your adventuring companions break into the Tomb of Keening Spirits. The entryway leads into an antechamber that could hold probably 100 people. Large, imposing, oversized architecture. Like everything here looks like it was scaled up for something bigger.
Hmm.
The hallways, the pillars... even this area that you're in, this antechamber, it looks like it opens up to something grander. And there's actually like a brick staircase of like single naked bricks sticking out against the wall. Go up to the very top for that little square part that juts out would be.
Mm.
And it looks like there's some sort of apparatus for leaving.
Okay. Well, that makes more sense.
There's seams on the inside of this place, too. Like, the whole place would open up like a flower.
Oh. Look how we can get that going.
Yeah. The floor and walls are covered with mosaics and stained glass kind of coverings of battles, revelries, important moments in history, legacies, just fantastic stuff.
Huh.
It has a very, I wouldn't say industrial, but a very almost kind of nouveau architecture. Something you haven't really seen in, like, First Age stuff.
Really?
Like, First Age kind of falls back to the kind of Mayan or very Babylonian kind of styles. This looks more almost classical Victorian, but so, with a very Asian twist to it.
So it's not something the Majestic would ever do, because he has a distinct style.
Yeah,
so.
I mean, you can tell something the Majestic's done from a mile away. They're all super similar in that kind of flavor they have.
Mm.
You know, there's a lot of pyramids and a lot of, like, reptilian kind of violence to it, draped up in, like, gold and jewelry and stuff. Mm-hmm. This looks like more like something you see out of a painter or, like a Neverland kind of, not Neverland, but like an Alice in Wonderland almost kind of mind.
Huh. This is kind of gorgeous.
Yeah. There's a kind of naked worship of violence in the stuff the Majestic does in his past lives.
Hmm.
Isn't here.
Yeah. Do we see any symbols of, like, a certain part of the sun, or...
This tomb would have probably been a zenith tomb.
Okay.
Yeah. Just from how you can tell, how it's kind of arranged, it looks more like a cathedral to the sun and to the zenith buried within than it does look a mausoleum to Ego.
Okay.
Or like a warrior's kind of armory.
Because,
hey, they've even if you have a Zenith who's, like, a war character, they're going to do it in the lens of, you know, a prophet.
Mm.
It's just how it works. It's why the casts exist.
Yeah.
So even if you have someone who's going to be Superman, but he's a Zenith, and he does all the combat stuff, he'll be through that kind of lens later. His tomb will end up being a cathedral as opposed to a armory.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Again, hallways, hugely oversized. It looks like they could fit... like, you could fit buildings in here, almost. Like, wow. Maybe 2-3-story buildings. There are antechambers for people to get through that if they were crawling on their hands and knees. That like, little, like, tunnels and stuff off the corridors. There are normal-sized doorways. There are pews everywhere, like, to sit down in and worship. Hanging fountains that are giving off water even now that run across the stained glass and drain underneath, and lights are kind of laying at the water to... focus the light through stained glass and water and stuff.
Okay. Does this place look lived in at all? Is it dusty? Is it...
Oh, man. Solar design stuff never has dust or age on it.
Spotless and beautiful?
Yeah.
Lived in at all? Like, is there a smell of someone, like, perfume or...
Tombs like this never allow that kind of stuff to set in.
Mm.
It's sterile. Or whatever it was originally built to be like has continued through to this age.
Okay. Poison smells of incense and stuff. Yeah.
Lotus petals.
Pretty.
Yeah.
Kind of just want to, you know... Well, no one's ever going to come in here. We can just keep this place.
It would make an excellent forward-operating installation.
Yeah.
Or we could cause the mass this thing obviously is to, you know, geomantically overreact and just take this place out.
Huh. It'd almost be... A little sad to do that. Someone put their heart and soul into this. I mean...
Worry not, Killer Queen. If this place truly was loved for its uniqueness that it brings to creation, it'll reflect itself into the underworld, where your ancestors and your dead friends can enjoy it evermore.
You make a fair point, actually. I don't know enough about the underworld to argue that, so I'm just gonna...
He's not lying, you know. Yeah, if you get ancestor cults in place to revere this place enough, and then destroy it, you'll send it reverberating as an echo into the underworld.
I kind of want to, like, take people from here and, like, yeah, you can just stay here and make into it. Yeah.
And then, you know, it'll become taxed, and the guild will, and whoever will set up shop in here.
Yeah.
Those people will be immediately kicked out.
Yeah, could I just say, like... Wait, could I just, like, let the guilds, like, hey, you want to take over this place? And
Oh, there you go.
Oh.
Feather in your cap.
Okay, that's good to know once we get rid of whoever is in here.
This large antechamber has a corridor, so think of, like, a circle with a... Think like a barbell.
Uh-huh.
There's another antechamber, and it has stairs that lead down across a center pillar.
Mm-hmm.
So, think of, like, a spiraling staircase, but when you look inward, it's all transparent and covered in, like, water. Like it's like a waterfall, kind of like in Pearl's room in Steven Universe. Okay. It has those waterfall columns, but that's encased in crystal and stained glass, and inside there's actually frozen bubbles of water that have, like, the remains of servants and stuff in them.
I'm irritated by how pretty this place is. It's like, wow. Oh, remains of servants? Like,
there's mortals and stuff that have been, like basically mummified and, like, covered in gold so you can't see any of their body.
Mm.
But they've just been, like, kind of sealed in and stuff, and they're just in these little bubbles that are floating on this staircase.
So it's not Yasuo crystals, it's just...
No, Yasuo crystals are for gods.
Mm.
But there's
literally
thousands of these just hovering around like ornaments.
Just favored people?
Yeah.
Okay.
Sometimes you see animals or horses or... like weird god-blooded creatures that have just been preserved here.
Mm. Have you ever found any of your tombs? Any of you?
Why would we have tombs, Lawgiver?
Oh, you don't reincarnate like us?
I don't believe there's been anything like us on the face of creation.
Huh.
We're a new type of means to an end.
Fair enough.
We're the first of our legacy.
Hmm.
As you brought down the Titans, so shall we herald in the beginning. The beginning of one final end.
Sounds like bullshit.
There weren't abyssals before this generation. Mm-hmm. For very specific reasons!
I don't think these guys are the first. We know there are other Death Lords out there, they just haven't come to creation.
Yeah.
No,
there's no other abyssals.
There are other abyssals. They all live in the underworld and stuff. You want to meet rival abyssals to this guy? These guys?
No, I'm just saying.
I would just sit there with them.
They're the first generation. All the abyssals are first generation abyssals.
Mm. Well, so you don't know if you... Well, I guess the Devastator would never reincarnate. He's kind of gone. But
no, his story ended. But perhaps he'll be an excellent footnote when we find his replacement. We are currently courting quite a strong candidate.
Oh, well.
Someone who's a little more hands-on.
The Devastator was pretty hands-on. Well,
if it works out, I think you'll find a certain humor in it.
Oh, man! Out of character! Oh, man!
The queen's just like, yeah, that sounds cool.
And then...
I wish you luck with that.
Thank you.
So, yeah, I guess we just go deeper down. Do you think you'll reincarnate, though? Like, you won't be thrown into the pits of oblivion, so do you think that's how yours works?
I don't know. Perhaps I'll continue on as a spirit, some sort of spectral entity. Perhaps if I serve the Neverborn, or my master enough, I will come back as a Nephrax serving the Mask of Winters.
I thought you lot were better than Nephrax.
You've seen Nephrax.
Unfortunately. They're
a certain flavor of labyrinthian design.
I can't say I've met one I liked.
Before there was the Mask of Winters, before there was any of this, the Nephrax preached the word of the Neverborn.
Hmm.
They're a very different sort of creature.
Yeah, they are. All right.
But we are related.
All right.
We both have an instinctual connection to the dead... the Titans that were.
Hmm. You just seem to have a little more together than a...
We're alive. True we're not enough. Ruled by our passions.
You really aren't. It's, admirable.
Yes.
So, staircase down?
Yeah, it takes probably half an hour just to go downstairs.
Mm-hmm.
And when you get to the end of it, it opens up kind of into a dome, which, yeah, the last areas were domed, but the last areas were more cylindrical. This area is like a large kind of dome antechamber. Damn it, I've used that word before. Whatever. The floor raises up very slightly into millions and millions of tiny steps carved from individual stones with symbols of the Unconquered on each stone, arranged together. Like, they've all been cut into almost puzzle pieces and arranged together in a flower formation.
Hmm.
So as you walk into the middle of this place, you slowly go up just a large amount of steps to a central kind of sarcophagi that is probably four men large.
Solar tomb? Or, like, solar sarcophagus?
Yeah. It has effigies on it of some sort of hoplite or some sort of priest lord on it with, like, the sun trailing behind it and scenes of Imperial Majesty carved into it with different stones and jewelry and materials.
Hey, I know this isn't what we came for, but you guys want to pop this sucker open?
Perhaps this is more your providence, Killer Queen.
Alright.
We will be ready for whatever may follow this action.
Yeah.
Your ancestors aren't... Your predecessors were not known for sharing with the next generation.
Well, that's their problem.
There's a large Yassel crystal in the ceiling that seems to be giving off inner light that is actually shining light on different incense burners and shrines in like the formation of the sun. Like it looks like it turns every once in a while as the sun changes, so like the primary beam goes from whatever station the sun would be in now.
All right. Just opening this alone seems like it'll attract the attention of whoever's in here, if they're not already watching. So, how does this thing open?
Alright, you hang out around it for a little bit.
Yeah, meditate on it, I guess.
It has, just straight kind of locks and hinges built into under the coffin lid.
Mm-hmm.
And it looks like if you, open them in a certain sequence, it'll open itself.
Okay. Does there seem to be any rhyme or rhythm to the,
You can bounce ideas off of the Abyssal Circle, and they're smart enough to figure this out as well. They're fairly well read.
They really are.
Yeah, like, you got a team with you.
Mm-hmm.
You know, this is like having the PCs with you, but with less drama. It's just much easier to work with these guys. And yeah, you basically are able to run your hand around certain symbols and whatnot, and the way the sarcophagi opens is it has a circular part at the top and what looks like wings down that separate down at the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
So the wings itself fold open and the circle retracts backwards, like the sarcophagi from Stargate.
Oh, okay. Of course.
Yes. Stargate is an excellent source of inspiration for what solar designed stuff looks like.
Mm-hmm.
Even down to the Jaffa warriors and like their helmets and shit.
Yep. Holy
Christ.
Alright, so I'm just going to kind of twist that around. And...
Oh yeah, so the tomb opens up, and like the wings and like the sun circle up the middle kind of open up, so it looks like there's a... They rise up on a hinge, so it looks like the sun has wings, and it's like above the body.
Mm-hmm.
It comes up on like kind of a crane and shines light onto it.
Mm.
And yeah, and there is a mummified body. It's wrapped in gold filigreed linens.
Okay, just the body.
It's clasping a diclave. It has a pariat on its head that has a hearthstone in it. There are various books and jewelry basically loaded into the side. They didn't dress it up before it died. They just kind of loaded it into the tomb with it.
Okay. Kun kind of sits on the rim. It's like, right, well, I don't think you're me, so I don't think you'd appreciate me taking your skull. I really need a zenith one, good god. But, you know.
Yeah, you've been in buildings you've used to own, and mm-hmm. and your circles you used to own. You're not getting anything from this tomb.
Yeah.
This isn't one of yours.
So she's like, so I'm just gonna pop this out, you know. Go for the hearthstone.
You're not taking the skull?
No, it's not the queen's. It's
oh,
not part
you
of the...
want one of your past skulls.
Yeah.
I see.
Okay.
So, diclave...
Yeah, it looks like a standard diclave. Like, it's not a grim one, or it's not a reaver. It's a diclave.
Artifact, though?
Or... Oh, they all are. Diclaves are always artifacts.
Oh, right, yes.
Sure. It's just there's different sizes and flavors of them, like rapier ones, or like choppy ones, or whatever. This is a diclave. It's a large slab of Vorchalcum sword.
But they weren't... You said they were buried with it, but it didn't seem like they were, like... It was just loaded in with them?
Well, yeah, they weren't dressed up in their stuff. They were just wrapped in proper burial shrouds. Like, their pamphlet was kind of loaded into the tomb itself and arranged in an appealing way.
Okay, well, it doesn't look like you were too attached to this.
You're gonna loot this fucking corpse?
Yeah.
You want a swag bag?
Yeah.
Okay, alright, you fucking defile and loot this corpse.
Okay, it's like, alright, so, rest well. I'm gonna use my power. Make sure he doesn't come back as an angry ghost. It's like, yeah. Rest in peace. He's like, I'm gonna get. Oh. All right. Anything?
They've been looking around, and they're like, "There's more to this place, but it looks like it's locked."
Ugh. Locked with what?
probably some sort of mechanism in here. Maybe something to do with these signs of the sun.
Okay.
The tomb lid looks like it's been opened recently. Like, you're not the first one to open it.
Oh, I see. Okay. Any other signs? Where they went? Probably into the locked part.
Yeah, it looks like this place has shutters. Like the walls of the dome you're in, like the cylindrical walls, would shutter open. Like, they'd pivot on their axis and open up.
All right, let's try to get that going. Let's try to
all right.
Shutters open.
Roll social. See how well you can get coordinate the team.
Okay.
8. All right. You're able to basically work with the abyssals and kind of crowdsource the problem, such as it were.
Hmm.
And eventually, Clad in Darkness, or no, not Clad in Darkness, the Topaz Lady goes to the tomb and just kind of lifts the body out and puts it outside of the sarcophagus and kind of pulls up some of the underside of the sarcophagus, and there's latching mechanisms in there.
Wow, how did I notice that?
It was hidden.
Yeah, true enough.
Like, that was the thing, like, that she had to, like, pull up something.
That was in character, though. The queen's like, man, I was digging around that corpse trying to find, like, little...
Yeah, and there's, like, a handle that she pulls up and twists and lets go of, and it drops back into the tomb, and the shutters start opening up.
Ah, nice.
So there's more to this place. Like, it's a bigger circle, essentially.
Mm-hmm.
There are resting rooms. There's, like, 400 soldiers that are all terracotta warriored up. With the whole eagle heads and whatnot, like Jaffa-style, Stargate-style guardians just standing there at attention, weapons in hand. There is a modest treasury with has slabs of jade and or chalcum in it. Weird first-age artifice, like Magitech. And one of the rooms, which, you know, they all have fairly high ceilings, has a war strider in it.
Okay, so after we loot this place, I'm really sending the guild here. This is good.
Yeah, the War Strider has that same kind of eagle heads motif that the Stargate Jaffa have.
Mm-hmm.
It's big, it has a large staff in its hand still on display, and you get a feeling after you and Void without taking a look at it that the staff itself generates a sigh from it, like an energy weapon.
Oh.
Yeah. The whole tomb kind of makes a little more sense now, because this thing can probably be walked in and out of it.
Okay. Well, we're gonna come back for you. Oh, yeah. How, resource-wise, how much would be in here, do you think?
Beyond resource 5.
Okay, we can pay off so much shit with this.
Yeah, this is good. This as kind of like your seed money with the guild and whatnot, would you have resources 5, and if you buy it with XP, you'd be able to lock in that you just have constant sources of income.
Okay. So, is there, one of the shutters that opened, is there a way further down?
No, looks like this is the whole tomb.
Oh, okay.
Like, the dome opens up a bit too onto the higher areas, and, like, more light kind of streams in everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
And Night of Curses is all kind of perks up her vampire ears. It's like, there is someone in here.
Watching.
Yeah, someone's hidden in here. They're being stealthy. She kind of backs away behind a pillar. I'll be right back.
Just gonna use the washroom again.
Sorry. Sure, we'll pause. All right. Night of Curses kind of makes a motion to you, like, talk them out of it. And she kind of goes behind a shadow and stealths.
All right. We know you're here. I'm assuming you know why I'm here. So, if you could just come out here, we can just skip the whole song and dance. You really don't want... You really don't want that. That's not even a threat. That's just...
Roll Persuade?
All right. Eleven?
Jesus Christ. Okay. In the background, like you guys are kind of looking around. There's a lot of light, and there's also a lot of stylistically created shadows around here.
Mm-hmm.
You see two figures move somewhere along the ceiling and the walls, and hear the sound of metal scraping against metal.
Are you doing this the hard way? Really, I'm not here to fight if it's not necessary. I just want what's mine. You took it, and, you know, we can forgive and forget, but I want it back.
Another persuade. You're getting really high.
7? That's all it takes.
I don't want a war. I don't want some drawn-out battle or revenge for this. It's not that big a deal. I just want it back. The Majestic wants it back. The Wanderer wants it back. The Wolf doesn't care, but he will want it back. I want it back.
Did you take out the skull?
He would probably want it back. He likes having kids. He really liked kids.
Vegeta?
To be clear, everyone.
Oh yeah, Kevin took out the Nightcast skull and was like muppeting it talking. Like a goddamn crazy person. Alright, another persuade. That's good.
10.
Alright. There's more sounds of scraping and stuff, and you can see two people separate, and Knight of Curses shows up behind you.
Oh, okay.
Oh, come on. And from one of the pillars by kind of where the panoply is, like where there's like all the weird magic tech and maybe scrolls and like art, a woman walks out.
All right. Does she seem recognizable at all? Do I get that feeling?
No. It's really hard to recognize sidereals because I don't really understand how they work.
Okay.
young, you know, probably early 20s, maybe even a little younger than that. Slight short build, bob cut, green hair, has like tattoos and like little like those kind of gem implants that people have sometimes.
Yeah.
And she's wearing robes that you've seen the Countess kind of stylize.
Really?
Huh. Like that, those kind of weird worshipping solar robes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. All right, Lawgiver. Call off your dark knights.
Right. It's all right now.
Are you sure?
I'm sure.
Very well. And they all kind of back off in a semicircle behind you.
I like this.
I like having underlings that are useful. Oh, fuck.
It's like, oh, God.
Oh, fuck.
That background music that always follows me.
Shit.
Edward, get out here.
God damn it.
I know you're here.
Oh, fuck. Whatever.
It works.
You defused the situation by having dice. Okay. All right. Let's talk.
Let's.
You're here for the infant?
I am.
Why?
It's... Queen kind of turns around for a moment, and she's like, fuck. It's of importance to my circle. It is a part of all of us.
Do you think it's going to be safe in 1 May?
It'll be safe in the center. You've been there, I think. It was safe enough, safe for you.
I've seen you guys. You're not stable.
Nothing is in this world.
I have the infant, it is.
Where is it?
One of our camps.
Why? Why did you take it?
Because you guys aren't very stable.
Why is that important? Why is it important to you? Yes, we did. Why does that matter to you? What importance is it to you that we made it?
Seemed important at the time.
Why us? There's babies everywhere. You could have grabbed one of them. I mean,
there isn't a baby made from a perfect circle of five lawgivers who are making the South come back. And my superiors, what's the word that she's looking for? Shit. Not senseis, that's stupid.
Senpais?
No, God, Christ, no. You fuck. Pause. The word, it was mentor. My mentors have... Oh, shit, what was she even saying before? Damn it, I forgot this entire...
The baby's safer with her than us.
All right, and my mentors have told me a bit about what you and your family is like over its incarnations. You don't have a reputation of stability, especially in the early days.
The early days.
Something you care about, though.
When you inevitably first start meeting up.
Oh, you know about our past incarnations.
My mentors know a thing or two about your specific legacy. And it's a little shocking of all the ones to be coming back, that yours would be the one to come back as quickly and as completely as it has, your Nightcast notwithstanding.
He's around.
So, I think with your knowledge of what you guys are like, it's not that outrageous that we, you know, took care of the kid for you.
Who are you? Like, who do you work for, exactly? I know you're of...
We work for a clandestine organization that wants to make sure that your rule is not as short-lived as it could be under the realm's influence.
And what is their right to tell us how to hold our rule?
What is your right to rule this place? Yes, you'll find we have similar jurisdiction. Like, listeners, he pointed to his caste mark, you know, the caste mark of the Unconquered Sun. So that was her rebuttal. It's like, we have similar jurisdiction over managing your affairs.
Look, I know mistakes were made during that ceremony, but it was a mistake that won't be repeated again at 1 May.
Where else? Your child is not only being well taken care of by people with resources and expertise going back literally millennia. It is also being given access to the best training and health and education that could be provided in a place that no one knows exists.
Have you seen Wan Mei? Have you seen the teacher that the Majestic is?
I've seen that you're stricken with a sort of wanderlust and attention span issues when it comes to goals.
All parents have flaws. Ours just happens to be a bit more...
And many rulers have nannies.
Yes, those nannies don't tend to kidnap children and take them to, what, heaven?
Not really.
Look, I've met your agents or whatever.
You met an assassin.
Like you.
I'm not an assassin. I'm more of a troubleshooter.
Yes,
I find troubles and shoot them.
What is your intention with this child?
Yeah, I'll just raise it till it can, like, walk and talk and hang out and stuff.
Then what?
Probably give it back to you.
Oh. Wait, so we don't have to take care of this thing. You'll mentor it. What will you teach it, philosophy-wise?
About how there's an order to the world, and certain people are at the top of that food chain. Under the rules of the Unconquered Sun, you know, the basics. Not too far from what your countess would teach it. Maybe a little less cannibally.
I like that better. Okay.
The look on Nicole's face. This is kind of why I didn't want anyone listening to each of these little individual sessions.
All right. Then there is one thing we should discuss. Visitation rights.
You know, we're going to start extending that once we could start talking.
Oh. You know, this is sounding a lot better than I expected.
Well, we've tried to send agents to contact you, but they all died.
Oh?
You have assassins after you, and it seems because of your wanderer and you, and a bit of the sea wolf, it's very hard for those assassins to kill you, so they've taken to intercepting our agents when they try to reach out to you.
That's irritating.
Comes with the territory. There aren't many champions of heaven that exist, so we tend... And we all work in the same place. Like, we have day jobs.
Oh, that sounds miserable.
It's fine. It's a living. So we tend not to try and murder our brothers and sisters, but we do have proxies. And it's really hard to get those proxies where they have to go. You made waves when you struck down the assassin sent after you.
Oh, yeah, that was...
You made some pretty startling waves, and that's made you enemies. Yeah. You scalped her.
Yeah, I've kind of got that in a jar at home.
You couldn't just take her hostage or something?
In retrospect, that might have been a better idea, but, you know, I'm me. You've seen what I do.
This is more to the point. Like, we're going to reach out to you eventually, but it's just... You're in a state of flux right now, especially with what's coming down onto Wan Mei soon.
The realm, yes.
Yeah, you need to push the realm back from this assault. They won't have the energy to do a second one.
Right.
This isn't a wild hunt. This is an actual military engagement.
In the case that they do strike us down, the child will be safe with you.
Yeah, we have our facilities. We have solars, fledgling solars, that we train in our facilities. We have them there now. Where do you think the Bull of the North got so good at what he was doing so fast?
Why didn't you approach us rather than just taking the child?
You took off too quickly. You sort of ran away with the whole reclaiming your dynasty thing. By the time we had noticed that you were a force in creation, you had already taken Wan Mei and started to expand it. By the time we'd even figured of getting people into a position to bring into the cult of the Illuminated, you had already turned it into a manse.
What is this cult exactly? They seem...
It's a mortal branch of our... It's kind of the mortal arm of our... sort of our human resources division. They kind of track down people like you and people associated with you who are sympathetic, and our agents are able to pick them up from there and bring them to actual facilities.
They seem ill-equipped.
There's always more mortals. What they lack in training, education, health, longevity, wisdom, insight, any of that, they make up for in numbers. And fanaticism. Their lives are miserable, so it's really easy to get them to think that these shining ones are going to show up from the edge of the world and save them from having to work to death until they're 30.
Right.
It's a very successful cult.
Right, well...
And then every once in a while, the Bull of the North goes around and wipes out an entire realm military legion. Or some sand people from the south set up a golden empire that gives out free food and water to everyone who wants it.
That did happen.
So, you guys are really helping that whole cult thing spread.
It was pretty great.
Yeah.
So, I've had second thoughts about all this, then. since, obviously, you sending your agents to Wan Mei isn't working, where can we get in touch with you?
Well, you can't meet me here now, because you just cracked open the tomb.
Yeah, that's going to be a problem.
I had a back door into here, and that's now compromised.
Yeah, that's not going to work. What about the other tombs?
They're not accessible. This place kind of started failing, so I was able to get in and use it as a staging area.
Hmm.
I had wards and scripture up on the inside that were bolstering the ghost's strength.
All right.
One of your associates should have access to heaven.
We can meet you there, then? That'll be...
It's pretty obvious who's for gold and who's for lack of a better metal, bronze.
For gold, I assume? That's the better metal, yes.
Yes. Bronze is easy to find, and there's a lot of it, but it doesn't just quite match up to the luster of gold.
Yeah. They don't have the best style, either. I mean, these robes are just kind of... Yeah, sorry about that whole thing. I wasn't quite thinking straight when I, did the whole thing with my claws.
Claws?
I tore out her throat.
Oh, yeah. It sucks. Someone else will replace her.
Oh.
But there's not a lot of us. Like, there's a lot of lawgivers on creation. Okay. There's a lot of dragon blood, a lot of terrestrials.
Mm.
There's a good amount of lawgivers. There aren't a lot of my people.
Wait, sorry. Was the bitch... Up north? Part of the gold faction?
No, she's bronze.
She's a bronze.
She's still just a serial, though.
Okay.
There are only 50 of us total.
Hmm. Does it only take, like, a bit of dragon blood to actually turn into one, or...?
No, just it happens sometimes. Dragonblooded have porked their way through so much of creation's bloodlines
that happen, yeah.
Anyone has the potential to dragon blood exalt.
Okay. Alright, well, yeah, that actually sounds like a better, idea, just letting you raise this thing. I am not good with children.
Alright. She kind of looks at Void with him without when you say that. Creepy little necromancer kid.
Except for that one. He's pretty good.
Because he's like a 50-year-old battle.
Exactly. He's like the perfect child.
I was talking about the other day where it's like, people with kids, when the babies cry, they hear that, like, they hear cooing and cutesiness or whatever. They're like, oh, it's a baby. Or like Nicole, if her ovaries getting tickled by baby cries. But like people without kids who don't like kids.
I wasn't even listening. And then what?
Something so people who don't like kids or aren't a fan of kids, when they hear babies cry, they hear sugar gliders crabbing. Please Google sugar glider crabbing to see exactly what we're talking about. That's the sound people without kids who don't really like kids hear.
My God.
Sugar gliders are the best animal. I'd have a fastener though if I could.
It's more about empathy than what the sound actually is.
The sound is a metaphor for empathy, Nicole.
So, yeah, we'll just get in contact with you in heaven, and this sounds way better than us raising it, to be honest.
Hey, that's kind of our whole deal. We do that kind of planning.
To be honest, I was mostly just concerned because I had no idea what the hell you were, and, you know, the Wanderer gave it to you. He could give it to, like, a Blood Ape, and he wouldn't realize the difference.
Need to know is kind of our creed where we come from.
Yeah, fair enough.
Well,
we can
make another one.
I said it's our fucking baby, you fucking bitch.
Oh my God.
Need to know.
Need to know. You didn't need to know.
On an off-topic thing, I'm so glad we didn't bring the Majestic here.
He's unstable, but that kind of applies to all of you.
He would be so angry right now. I can picture in my head exactly what he would be saying.
Yes, he seems a bit overly sentimental for someone of his station.
Yeah, I think most of them saw it for like 10 seconds, 20, maybe.
Quick, what was its name? What was its gender?
What is it? I need to know this.
It's alright.
I kind of named it Wanmei after the fact, but like...
We didn't name it Wanmei. We gave it a real name.
Can I know that name at least?
Station. We'll fill you in once it's old enough.
Okay.
We don't want you knowing any facts that could lead to its discovery or its gender.
Ugh.
You know, in case you're, like, tortured or something.
Did you name it Frisk?
God damn it, Kevin. Okay. Oh my God. Listeners, if you can see Nicole's little pouty, angry, Leslie Nope face.
Okay, can you give me at least some sort of evidence that I know this? That, you know, I actually met you and know all this, but they don't think I just went on a big drug dream.
She, like, gestures at the Warstrider.
That is a good point. They
and
will
all the
like
money?
That. They will like that.
Just loot this place. Just loot it hard.
Yeah. I kind of want to take all this material and just rebuild it in my place.
Oh my God, Nicole looks so angry.
We're transporting all this. We're just taking out the whole thing.
All right. Well, it was nice meeting you.
You too. It's been a pleasure.
Chip shakes your hand. I'm going to leave.
So am I. After I loot this place a bit more.
And she just kind of walks up the stairs.
Well, that ended well. What a very sensible ending to this little adventure of ours. We want to go to a bar, you know, we can drink before we go back.
That might be. We should look into cataloging what's here.
Yes, and then we'll get the guild in here. Once we take in what's ours, that War Strider is coming back with us.
Mm-hmm. Yes, you all have a very cordial meetup with that Sidereal, who you didn't know name. You know her gender, but not her name, or even her caste. You don't know the baby's gender or name, or where it is. You just know that it's probably okay, and definitely didn't die of SIDS earlier.
The queen doesn't care. She has that word, and it doesn't matter anymore, because it's like, hey, I didn't fuck everything up, now it's her fault.
Alright, it's good. You successfully found out what happened to the baby, and one day you'll get visitation rights and be able to hang out with it. You'll be allowed to, Nicole. Allowed.
Once they're no longer afraid of us shaking it too hard.
Or letting its little weak neck break or whatever.
It's just every time the queen is holding the baby, the scenario's there, it's like, hold the head, support the head, oh God.
Support the head, how are you so bad at this? All right, you know what? I think that's good. Any thoughts, Kevin, before we end?
That went really well.
All right, good session. Had fun with that?
Yeah.
Perfect. That's all that matters.
And fun, reader or followers,
people, listeners. Alright, listeners, I guess the next two are the Majestic and the Wanderers. Something tells me we'll do the Majestics before the Wanderers. Mm-hmm. Anthony lives in the sticks.
Yes, he does.
And end.